Good morning, Sagittarius, and welcome to my channel, Cancer Moon Oracles. My name is Rosa, and I am coming in with your weekly love reading, where specifically in this video, we're going to take a look at your person's current feelings towards you. So whoever it is that you are connecting to and dealing with in love is the energy of the person we're going to be reading today. This is a general reading as always, and if it resonates with you, please hit the like button to let me know. This reading can be good for Sun, Moon, Venus and Rising Sagittarian placements. And to the cross watchers, you're also welcome. Feel free to take the messages as your own, as it can feel like I'm speaking more directly to you. But otherwise, I do highly recommend to check out your Moon sign, your Rising sign and your Venus sign if you feel that your message isn't here today. And two, there's always a personal booking. I do recommend a personal booking in that instance because it's going to be more specific and suited to what you're currently going through. If that's something that you're interested in, Sagittarius, then all the details on how to work with me will be in the descriptions box below. Okay, so we're going to open up the reading by drawing four cards from the Golden Tarot. We will clarify these cards using the Rider-Waite, and then towards the end of the reading, we will draw some last parting messages and or advice, whichever wants to come through first. So let's begin your reading, Spirit Angels and Guides. Please show us how this person currently feels towards Sagittarius. I wanted to say Scorpio, so for some of you, you may be connecting to a Scorpio. Spirit Angels and Guides, please show us this person's current feelings towards Sagittarius. What is it that Sagittarius needs to know when it comes to this person's current feelings towards Sagittarius? I'm just going to split the deck. The cards are a little bit slippery. Okay, let's take a look. First card coming through is the Ten of Pentacles. Well, that's a nice strong start. So this person sees you as a long-term potential. Okay, they see you in their future. This is someone who wants to build a life with you. This is someone who wants a solid and stable relationship. Because they can see you in their future. This is someone who desires to have a family someday. And they can see themselves having this family with you. That's not going to speak for all of you though. For others of you, this person just can see you being the person that they want to do life with. Yeah. They can see you being that person they want to do life with. I feel like this is someone who has like a lot of goals that they would like to achieve, but they see you as being the person that they want to achieve these goals with. Okay. All right, let's see what else is coming through. The Ace of Wands. This could be someone new that you've recently connected to. The Ace of Wands, it does speak to something new. I feel like this is someone who feels very excited about their future. Okay, they're excited about the future and they want to start making plans towards greater stability here with you. They're going to start making plans to put this in motion. Okay, this is someone who wants to act. Okay, they want to take action and they want to act on these feelings. The The desire to be with you long term with this Ace of Wands, it feels very strong because this ace, this wand is very big. So I feel like the desire to create greater stability here with you is very strong. And this person is really excited to get plans moving here with you. This is someone who is very attracted to you. They're getting this idea this week, okay? It's like an idea is being downloaded to them that they want to start working towards these goals with you. It could be like a commitment. It's just greater stability in general. Okay, what look at this. Four of Wands. That's really beautiful energy, Sagittarius. The Four of Wands, it's a strong, secure, stable relationship. You know, it represents two people celebrating their love for one another. You know, this is two people coming together, solidifying a connection, solidifying a relationship, possibly with marriage. Okay, we will clarify. For some of you Sagittarians, I'm seeing the 11-11 here. So this person could see you as like their twin flame, or they see you as their better half. This could be someone this week. Really just depends. This is not going to be for all of you, but for a portion of you Sagittarians, this person wants to make your situation exclusive. So it's like they want to announce to family and friends that you guys are an item, or that you're moving in together. Maybe I can see you guys moving in together, or I see this person having this vision here, or this idea that they're ready to move in together, or they're ready to start a family here with you. They're ready to settle down. They're definitely ready to take the relationship to the next level. Okay, we've got the Five of Cups. That's an interesting card to get, the Five of Cups. The Five of Cups. It's the Five of Cups is half of Ten of Cups. Okay, so in order to have the Ten of Cups, we need two people that want to be in a relationship. Okay, that love each other and that obviously want to invest emotionally into a relationship. This person may feel like it's too late is what I want to say. They may feel sad because they feel they're the only ones that want this. Or they may feel that you don't want this. We need to explore this. We need to understand this. So I'm just going to leave that there for a moment. Actually, do I want to clarify it first? Let me clarify it, Sagittarius. Sorry, I'm just trying to hear what Spirit's saying to me. Spirit, angels, and guides, why is the Five of Cups here? Why is the Five of Cups here? The Emperor. This is someone who sees them being like your divine counterpart here. This is strong, divine masculine energy. It's either this person is divine masculine or they see you as the divine masculine. could be an Aries that you're connecting to. All right, let's take a look here. Page of Wands, fire energy, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. This is someone, Sagittarius, that they're excited about making plans. They're excited about making future plans here with you, but there is something from their past that haunts them. Maybe they feel like you're going to leave them, because I see this man, he's looking at three cups that are spilt over. Maybe they feel with the Page of Wands here that you're going to leave them, or that you're going to lose interest in them. I don't know why that's coming in. I feel like maybe because the Page of Wands is, it's like a young energy, it's a playful energy, it's a flirty energy. This person may feel like you only maybe consider them as a friend, or you may only consider them as someone that you like to fool around with or have fun with. But that's the other message that I'm getting. Yeah, there's just something here from the past that haunts them, that troubles them. I feel like they try not to let this past situation trouble them. Because the Emperor is the energy of someone who's kind of like a soldier. They pick themselves up and they keep going, you know. But yeah, there's just something from the past here that haunts them. That's what I want to say there. Okay. Why is the Ten of Pentacles here? The Knight of Pentacles. Earth energy, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. You could be connecting to an earth sign here. Yeah, this is definitely someone who is making future plans that involve you, okay? This is someone who is thinking long and hard about their future. They're thinking long and hard about where they want to invest their pentacle and who they want to invest their pentacle into. I feel like this is someone who is ready to settle down. This is someone who is ready to, yeah, settle down. And establish roots with someone. Okay, let's see what else is coming through. The Eight of Wands. Yes, I definitely feel that this person, they feel ready, okay? They feel ready to move forward on these plans. They desire to put these plans in motion now, because these Eight Wands, they're in flight. Okay, they feel in their heart of hearts that they have the green light to move forward on these plans. Okay, and I feel like the Eight of Wands is, it's also a card of communication. So they will express this to you. They will talk to you about this. So this is something you can expect this week. This may be someone who is at a distance from you too, Sagittarius. This may be someone who needs to travel to come towards you. Or maybe they're hoping you travel to move to their location, because I do see travel in this card. Why is the Ace of Wands here? The Magician. I like that. This person is definitely wielding their wand. Okay, this wand is alive with energy and passion and desire. This person desires to act on their plans for you, or with you, that their plans that involve a future with you. This is someone with the Magician who feels very capable and feels very ready. Yeah, like I'm feeling it at a heart level for this person, right? The Two of Pentacles. The Two of Pentacles tells me that they're ready to thread their life in with yours. It's kind of like they're ready to intertwine, you know, their life with your life. You know, they're ready to, intertwine themselves with you. It's like they are one pentacle and you are the other, and they're ready to combine these pentacles together. You know, and I'm seeing this infinity symbol above the Magician as well. You know, it's strong on their mind. And they want to manifest this in the real world. Okay. They have this idea and they want to manifest this idea into reality. They want to make it real. And it feels like with the Two of Pentacles here that they will maneuver things around and they will reschedule their plans to accommodate these new plans. Okay, they are going to move things around in their life to accommodate this idea that they have that involves you. All right. But they definitely feel here with the Two of Pentacles that they can do it. They can do it. They can manage this because you're a priority for them. Okay, why is the Four of Wands here? See, the Star card is here. The Major Arcana for Aquarius. So you could be connecting to an Aquarius. This person is feeling hopeful and positive about a future here with you. You may be at a distance from them, but I feel like they want to close that distance. It might be physical distance here. So like I said, if you're an hour away, if you live an hour away from each other, or if this is like a long distance relationship, it's like they want to relocate to be closer to you here. This is someone who sees you as the one. Okay, no doubt about it, no questions about it. They see you as the one. All right. And this is someone who wants to show you off. They want to show you off to your family and to family and friends. Look at this, the World card. Wow. You could be connecting to a Scorpio, an Aquarius, a Taurus, or a Leo here. getting strong Aquarius energy. This is someone who wants to center their life around you. Okay, I'm seeing you as the woman in this world card. They want to center their life around you. They're making you the priority here. Okay, it's like you're the center of their universe. They want to make you feel like you're the center of their universe. Yeah, I'm just getting very strongly here that everything they're doing here is centered around you and your connection to them. The world is, it's a triumphant energy, and I feel like this person wants to achieve like victory in the way of really solidifying this relationship and solidifying this connection. I definitely see a marriage on the cards. Okay, I see, I'm just seeing a beautiful celebration here, like a ceremony here. So like your love is going to be celebrated, or they want to celebrate your love. If you're already, you know what, this is a side message. If you're already married to this person, it's like they want to renew the vows. It's kind of like that energy. For some of you who are already married and you already have a family with this person, they want to renew the vows here with you. And maybe that's why the Five of Cups is here, because maybe they, you know, they regret something that they did in the past, and this is their way of proving their love to you, okay? Because with the Emperor here, this is someone who is very committed to you, who is very committed to the connection. You're very important. The Emperor is someone who is stepping up. They're taking accountability. They're taking responsibility. You're their responsibility. You're they just feel a sense of maybe obligation and duty to you. Okay. This is also an energy of someone with the Five of Cups who is looking to the past with sadness, but it's almost like they need to say goodbye to their past. You know, so if they do, for example, live at a distance from you, it's like they're saying goodbye to their past, but they are also very excited here with the Page of Wands about starting a new life and a future here with you. So that's the messages that I'm getting. Let's grab some last parting messages and or advice, or whichever wants to come first. Sagittarius, if any part of this reading should resonate, please hit that like button to let me know. Drop your comments in the comments section below. Let me know which part best resonated for you. This was a different energy reading today. I'm also seeing here, sorry, spirits calling me over here again. The Page of Wands is someone who maybe you've recently been connecting to and seeing. I feel like the Page of Wands is kind of like still in the early stages of a relationship. But this is someone with the Emperor who is wanting to get serious here with you, okay? And it's like with the Five of Cups, they're grieving an old life, but they're also excited for their new life or their new chapter. Okay, we have Nightingale Spirit. Love is all around. Beautiful messages coming in here, Sagittarius. You're definitely going to be feeling the love this week from this person, okay? Yeah, you're feeling the love. You're going to feel the love coming in this week. We have Buffalo Spirit. The abundant universe will provide. The abundant universe will provide. Well, again, I feel like it's connected with the first message. You're going to feel the love. okay? And there's like an abundance of this love coming in, or there's like this heart opening or this heart expansion that is happening this week. It feels like, it feels lucky, it feels abundant, it feels prosperous. That's what it feels like. I can't even put it into words, but these are just some key words here. We've got turtle spirit, slow and steady wins the race. Slow and steady wins the race. Okay, so for some of you, especially with the Knight of Pentacles here and the turtle, this relationship may have been moving very steadily or very slowly, but it is moving steadily. And I feel like it's actually going to start picking up pace now. I feel like with the turtle spirit, maybe you have felt like things have been moving slowly here. But that's where, the universe steps in, because I feel like this is shifting gears this week with the abundant universe will provide. It's like things have been traveling very slowly here, but it's like the universe is switching gears and all of a sudden it's starting to pick up pace, which I feel like you will appreciate, Sagittarius. I feel like you have been patient, maybe, with this person. So there's your reading, guys. I do hope that was insightful and helpful. Feel free to drop your comments in the comment section below. Thank you for sharing your energy here with me today, and I will see you in my next video. Bye, guys.